Okay, good afternoon, Pak Gus and friends. Today, our group will explain about the burnishing process, and our group members are Adip Maratna Ningtyas, Savana Sita Kamila, and Roma Irwandi. Okay, so the definition of burnishing process. Burnishing is a cold working process in which plastic deformation occurs by applying pressure through a ball or roller on metallic surfaces. And here is the example of the burnishing process. Here is the example for the roller that apply on metallic surfaces. And then next, and for the advantages and disadvantages, the advantages from burnishing process are mirror like surface finish, dimensional consistency or repeatability, single pass operation, increase in surface hardness, reduces the reworks and rejections, adjustable setting, and save time. And the disadvantages from burnishing process are the initial cost for a burnishing tool is high, cannot be applied on miniature workspace. Components with thinner walls cannot be burnished because the force applied during burnishing are generally high. And then the last is burnishing of intricate shapes and contours requires dedicated tools and highly skilled workmen. And the next will be explained by Tias.
So here we have the first kind of burnishing, which is roller burnishing. Roller burnishing works like a roller flattering an uneven road. And the main goal of roller burnishing is to achieve high quality, smooth surfaces or surfaces with predefined surface finish. Roller burnishing using very smooth roller rolling by processing the surface of the metal. And here we have four types of roller burnishing tools that are multi-roller tools, single roller tools, diamond burnishing tools, and forming tools. Next slide is about roller burnishing process. So the first picture is workpiece quality before burnishing. As we can see, the workpiece quality is very rough and we have peak and valley there. And when we perform burnishing process, the roller will flatten the workpiece, and as the roller moves across the workpiece surface, the surface peaks are pressed down almost vertically into the surface, and the material then flows into the valleys between the peaks. So this is where we perform cold working or cold rolling, where the resulting smooth surface occurs not because the peaks are bent into the surface, but because the material flows, eliminating surface roughness. And finally, we have surface finish with criteria such as low roughness or defined roughness, rounded surface profile, high surface bearing ratio, less friction and wear, and increased hardness through cold working. The next slide is the example of roller burnishing surface finish. And here we, in the right side is the material after roller burnishing process, and the left side is the material before burnishing process. And we can see the obvious difference there. So that was all from roller burnishing. And the next is roller burnishing that will be explained by Kasafa.
The second type of burnishing is roller burnishing. Through ball burnishing, surface with complex configuration can be produced, giving them a good surface finish. This process is developed using a tool that is mounted on a hydraulic head, which applies pressure to the ball. This ball acts as a tool in deforming the surface layer of a workpiece. Next slide. Next is ball burnishing process. When the ball is going beyond the surface to mechanize in back and forth motion, it produces a plastic deformation in the material, eliminating the peaks and the surface irregularities, flattening the profile, and finally improve surface finish. Next slide. And here is the example of a surface finish ball burnishing process. The left side is the before process and the right side is after process. Next slide. And here are the references that we used in this presentation. That's all from us, from burnishing process. If you have any question, don't hesitate to ask. Thank you.